Kicking off 2017, Jeremy Corbyn proposed a policy of introducing a maximum wage. In case economics is not your strong point, in this video I'll briefly explain the issues with such a policy. The top 1% pay 27.5% of all income tax collected. If you reduce someone's income, you reduce the amount they pay tax on. Putting a maximum wage of £150,000 in place is estimated to result in a reduction in tax collected of £26 billion a year, approximately equal to the cost of all primary school education. So either there would need to be big cuts to government spending to make this up, or everyone else would need to be taxed more. We would also see people leave the country so they could get paid more elsewhere, taking all their taxable income with them, their general expenditure, and their skills. By way of example, let's talk about footballers. As Corbyn has talked quite a bit about them before, the average Premiership footballer gets paid £2.3 million a year. That is a lot of money. There's no two ways about it. Now, if you cap their salaries at still quite a high rate, say £500,000 a year, that would be a gross reduction of £1.8 million. If you were a footballer and had your earnings cut to about a fifth of what they were now, what would you do? A lot of them would go play abroad. Why not move to Spain, Italy, France, Germany, America, or even China if you could massively increase your salary? So this would result in a loss of talent. Just as an aside, if the players were convinced to somehow stay, it wouldn't reduce season ticket prices. Companies set prices to maximise profits. If people were still willing to pay the same amount, they would charge the same amount. Maximum salaries isn't a new idea. A maximum wage law was passed in Egypt, applying to various public bodies. Within 6 months, over 250 banking officials resigned. When skilled people leave, the term used is brain drain. Cuba and Venezuela also have maximum wage laws. In Cuba, it's a fixed amount, in Venezuela, it's relative to the lowest earning salary. Both countries' economies are a mess, but to be fair, it's not just the wage laws that have caused that. There are a number of reasons why such policies seem attractive. Some people are envious of people that earn more than them, others have a weak understanding of economics and think that everything's a win-lose situation and that there is a finite amount of money in the world. This is not true. Value is created by people engaging in mutual beneficial trades. If you stop people from earning, they stop, or at least do less of, the thing that was valuable, that was enabling them to earn the wages. It's very easy to look at a high-paid footballer and think, are they really worth it? But the answer is yes, that is how much society is valuing watching them play. If you don't like Premiership footballers earning a lot, don't watch them. If you would still like to see some football, go support the team in the lower leagues, they're a lot of fun. The reason more people don't do this is because a lot of people like to see football played at the highest standard possible. The footballers are providing service, and people are voluntarily choosing to watch. Steve Jobs didn't get rich because he stole from people. He developed stuff that people wanted. You spend £300 on a phone, it means that that phone is worth more to you than £300. If it wasn't, you wouldn't buy it. You get something you want, Apple gets some of your money in return. Now I'm actually going to go further and say that wealth inequality can be a good thing. It helps bring forwards innovation. In the 1980s, it was only the very well-off that had mobile phones, but it was due to that market existing that more cost-effective technology was developed. Now pretty much everyone has a phone, and a large proportion of people in sub-Saharan Africa do. Imagine how that's changed their lives. I do not care that rich people are rich. As long as they have stayed within the law, which involves not doing any dodgy dealings with government, the only way they could have earned their money is by helping other people. The purpose of the maximum wage law is to hurt the rich, but in so doing, it hurts everyone, through a drop in income tax revenue and other distortions in the market. I do care about moving people out of poverty, but this policy does not achieve that. It will have the opposite effect. We want to make the poor richer, not the rich poorer. Is Corbyn really going to go to hard-up families and say, I know I've made your lives more difficult, but on the plus side, I've made some other people worse off too. This is communism.